Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Item-based collaborative filtering is also called item-item collaborative filtering. It is a type of recommendation system algorithm that uses item similarity to make product recommendations. In this tutorial, we will talk about what is item-based collaborative filtering, how to create a user product matrix, how to identify similar items, how to rank items for the recommendation. Let's get started. Firstly, let's understand how item-based collaborative filtering works. Item-based collaborative filtering makes recommendations based on user-product interactions in the past. The assumption behind the algorithm is that users like similar products and dislike similar products, so they give similar ratings to similar products. Item-based collaborative filtering algorithm usually has the following steps. Calculate item similarity scores based on all the user ratings. Identify the top N items that are most similar to the item of interest. Calculate the weighted average score for the most similar items by the user. Rank items based on the score and pick top N items to recommend. This graph illustrates how item-based collaborative filtering works using a simplified example. Ms. Blonde likes apples, watermelons, and pineapples. Ms. Black likes watermelons and pineapples. Ms. Purple likes watermelons and grapes. Because watermelons and pineapples are liked by the same persons, they are considered similar items. Since Ms. Purple likes watermelons and Ms. Purple has not been exposed to pineapples yet, the recommendation system recommends pineapples to Ms. Purple. In the first step, we will import Python libraries pandas, numpy, and scipy stats. These three libraries are for data processing and calculations. We also imported Seaborn for visualization and cosine similarity for calculating similarity scores. This tutorial uses the Movielands dataset. This dataset contains actual user ratings of movies. In step 2, we will follow the steps below to get the datasets. Go to grouplands.org/datasets/movielands. Download the 100K dataset with the file name mllatestsmall.zip. Unzip mllatestsmall.zip. Copy the mllatestsmall folder to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. There are multiple datasets in the 100K Movielands folder. For this tutorial, we will use ratings and movies. Now let's read in the rating data. There are four columns in the ratings dataset: userid, movieid, rating, and timestamp. The dataset has over 100K records, and there is no missing data. The 100K ratings are from 610 users on 9724 movies. The rating has 10 unique values from 0.5 to 5. Next, let's read in the movies data to get the movie names. The movies dataset has movieid, title, and genres. Using movieid as the matching key, we appended movie information to the rating dataset and named it DF. So now we have the movie title and movie rating in the same dataset. In step 3, we need to filter the movies and keep only those with over 100 ratings for the analysis. This is to make the calculation manageable by the Google Colab memory. To do that, we first group the movies by title, count the number of ratings, and keep only the movies with greater than 100 ratings. The average ratings for the movies are calculated as well. From the info output, we can see that there are 134 movies left. Let's check what the most popular movies and their ratings are. Next, let's use a joint plot to check the correlation between the average rating and the number of ratings. We can see an upward trend from the scatter plot, showing that popular movies get higher ratings. The average rating distribution shows that most movies in the dataset have an average rating of around 4. The number of rating distribution shows that most movies have less than 150 ratings. To keep only the 134 movies with more than 100 ratings, we need to join the movie with the user rating level data frame. How equals inner and on equals title ensure that only the movies with more than 100 ratings are included. After filtering the movies with over 100 ratings, we have 597 users that rated 134 movies. In step 4, we will transform the dataset into a matrix format. the rows of the matrix are movies, and the columns of the matrix are users. The value of the matrix is the user rating of the movie if there is a rating. Otherwise, it shows none. In step 5, we will normalize the data by subtracting the average rating of each movie. The cosine similarity calculated based on the normalized data is called mean-centered cosine similarity. After normalization, the ratings less than the movie's average rating get a negative value, and the ratings more than the movie's average rating get a positive value. If you find the contents helpful so far, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. There are different ways to measure similarities. Pearson correlation and cosine similarity are two widely used methods. In this tutorial, we will calculate the item similarity matrix using Pearson correlation. Those who are interested in using cosine similarity can refer to this code. Since cosine similarity does not take missing values, we need to impute the missing values with 0 seconds before the calculation. In the movie similarity matrix, the values range from -1 to 1, where -1 means opposite movie similarity and 1 means very high movie similarity. In step 7, we will predict a user's rating for one movie. Let's use user 1 in the movie American Pie as an example. The prediction follows the process below. 1. Create a list of the movies that user 1 has watched and rated. 2. Rank the similarities between the movies user 1 rated and American Pie. 3. Select top-end movies with highest similarity scores. 4. Calculate the predicted rating using weighted average of similarity scores and the ratings from user 1. Now let's implement the process using Python. Firstly, we removed all the movies that have a missing rating for user 1 and sorted the movies by the ratings. We can see that user 1's favorite movie is Dumb and Dumber, followed by Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Next, we get the similarity score of the movie American Pie with the movie user 1 has watched, and pick the top 5 movies with the highest similarity score. After that, calculate the weighted average of ratings and similarity scores, so the movies with higher similarity scores get more weight. This weighted average is the predicted rating for American Pie by user 1. In step 8, we will create an item movie recommendation system following 4 steps. 1. Create a list of movie that the target user has not watched before. 2. Loop through the unwatched movies and create predicted scores for each movie. 3. Rank the predicted score of unwatched movie from high to low. 4. Select the top K movies as the recommendations for the target user. The Python function below implemented the 4 steps. With the input of picked user it, number of similar items, and number of recommendations, we can get the top movies for the user and their corresponding ratings. Note that the ratings are normalized by extracting the average rating for the movie, so we need to add the average value back to the predicted ratings if we want the predicted ratings to be on the same scale as the original ratings. In this tutorial, we went over how to build an item-based collaborative filtering recommendation system. You learned: what is item-based collaborative filtering? How to create a user product matrix? How to identify similar items? How to rank items for the recommendation? If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.